Welcome back, dear viewers. You're still watching The Breakfast Show live on Nile TV International. It's now time for our first topic of discussion for today. And as we noted in our introduction, the Ministry of Tourism and Antiquities is keen to develop a comprehensive promotional plan with modern technologies to coincide with hosting international sporting events. And with the beginning of 2021, Egypt was able to host the 27th edition of the International Handball World Cup for men on Wednesday, starting from the 13th of Jan till the end of the month. And to shed more light on this topic and its impact or ramifications on the tourism sector, we're most delighted to be joined here in the studio by Mrs. Nagam Muhammad Ali, a tourism expert and the sales and marketing director of a group of hotels. A very good morning, Mrs. Nagam, and thank you so much for joining us on The Breakfast Show.
Good morning, and thank you for inviting me.
Thank you so much for being with us. First of all, what do you think is the significance of hosting the International Handball World Cup in Egypt and its impact on the tourism sector?
To start with, of course, it's a very good step. It's been the whole tournament has been inaugurated by the president because it's quite important event for Egypt. Let me start with something different so that when we shed light, we are talking to the same direction. Let me introduce or say what's the definition of marketing. If we read it carefully, it says marketing is the activity, set of instructions, and process for creating, communicating, delivering, and exchanging offering that have value for customers. In addition, the New York Times have added as well, it is telling a story to people. This means what? This is in order to relate it to your question, which is a very important thing. The Ministry of Tourism have been identifying the importance of marketing. It's quite important to tell people the story. So this is how it's related to marketing. So in order to market Egypt, the first thing to do is to ensure that you're using the technology, as you exactly mentioned, that we're stressing on the technology. So we are aiming to show people, to show around our story. What's our story now? We are in a different era. We are going into the direction that everyone in the world has been going through. We have the technology. We're announcing this everywhere. Now the technology is around social media, is around telling your story on the moment, on the spot, so that everybody knows what's going on. Of course, getting back into the main subject, the tournament is one of the events that's very important. Being the host for the world for this tournament is quite an important event. It could have been, of course, great to have audience and sell tickets because this causes revenue or shares revenue as well for the country. Unfortunately, due to what's happening in the whole world, they stopped having the tournament announced and being sold as selling tickets for the audience and so on. But still, you're watching every moment and you're sharing all the information of the tournament around the world, moment by moment, what's happening and so on. So
you've seen also videos and photos for players by the sea, by the pyramids.
That's exactly what we're talking about, marketing. What's here marketing about? First, we're starting by the marketing campaign that we just shared with our audience this morning, that we are talking about Egypt. We're not talking directly, but this is how you you propose Egypt to the world, that you have a nice life. It's a combination between culture and modern life. You're seeing one of the famous singers. He's singing, dancing, like the rest of the world. So you're showing that you're life, because a lot of countries does not have enough Egypt, and they think we're still having only the desert and the camels. And this is a question everywhere, by the way. Whenever you when we used to travel, it was a question. So now it's showing. We do have the desert, and we do have the life of the Bedouin life, the camels, the culture.
Diverse life, yes.
Of course. The diversity is, yes, we are dancing in this area and having activities. We're having sports activities. We're having cities. Now, coming to what you have just mentioned, all the players are being watched while mm-hmm. having photos mm-hmm. in the cities they are playing in mm-hmm. around the sea. Mm-hmm. So this is an indirect marketing, what mm-hmm. we have, mm-hmm. beautiful beaches. Mm-hmm. You're having the sun, mm-hmm. which every part of the world, with an exception of very few parts mm-hmm. of the world, don't have sun. Mm-hmm. If you ask Europe now, they're having snow, they're having rain, mm-hmm. they cannot go out because
lockdown.
Of everything.
Yes.
They're locked down mm-hmm. and they don't have the weather to go out.
Yes.
And the sun have prevented Egypt mm-hmm. from the viruses mm-hmm. during the sun,
yes.
during the summer,
yes.
because of the heat. Mm-hmm. And now you're enjoying, we can experience all the beautiful weather right mm-hmm. now. You're almost
in Jan and yeah.
Yes, mm. while they're having a terrible
Celsius, yeah.
exactly. Mm. So you are showing as well what you have in the country. So mm. this is part of the marketing for the ministry, for the country as well. Mm. Not only that, you can see that we have concentrated on different areas like the infrastructure. Mm. You're having a lot of beautiful roads. Mm. You're having Cairo by night, the directions, mm. the Nile, mm. The activities. Mm. There is a couple of shots where you have the entertainment.
Mm.
Yes, we don't have much entertainment right now, but mm. still mm-hmm. you could see it.
It's lively.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. absolutely.
Yes. Mrs. Nagam, also, how do you see the echo of the event within the international community as where Egypt is hosting this tournament, World Championship, in the midst of a pandemic that has brought several countries to complete lockdowns?
It shows trust, mm-hmm. number one. Mm-hmm. Being chosen, this means that they do have trust of what Egypt is going to prepare.
Incapable of.
Mm-hmm. We could have seen as well that within the filming, the start filming, mm-hmm. the promotional one, there was the precautions that been given during this period mm-hmm. Against the COVID. Mm-hmm. We have seen people in masks and they're trying to spray an area.
To disinfect.
It's just a quick shot, but mm-hmm. it's an indirect messaging mm-hmm. saying, yes, we do care for people. Mm-hmm. We're wearing masks. Mm-hmm. We are infecting places. Mm-hmm. We are having our measures that mm-hmm. are following the World Health Organization. Yes, we did not say it, mm-hmm. but it can be shown from the filming mm-hmm. and from the way they're doing it. Mm-hmm. So it's very obvious.
Yes. Also, Mrs. Nagam, speaking about the COVID, how do you view the precautionary measures taken before the tournament has kicked off and the players staying in the bubble so that they're not susceptible of getting any contagion or infection?
This is a very good issue to talk mm. and to raise right now mm. because, as we said, it's something that that the whole world have seen mm-hmm. that we are trusted to host the tournament mm-hmm. and this means as well that they trust Egypt to take care on the health side of their players mm-hmm. so this they will see and film I think and there is a lot of photos around that mm-hmm. how we are treating them how we are spraying everywhere mm-hmm. Not only that there was a kind of inside or local information, and I'm sure it has been broadcasted as well to mm. the whole world, that the army have been taking some measures mm. into certain areas yeah. where you have a lot of nationals gathered. Mm. They're spraying, they are giving masks, they are taking measures of having the temperature mm. of the normal citizens. Mm. They're not selecting people mm. and doing the measures, mm. but they're just staying in the streets to show mm. that we do care for the nationals, mm-hmm. not only for the internationals. Mm-hmm. So everybody is under the health precautions mm-hmm. of the country, let alone if you are having or you're hosting guests, mm-hmm. players, guests, whatever. Mm-hmm. So you are showing the measures, whether in the streets, in the areas that they are stadium, playing in, the hotels, how they are treated in the from the arrival, from the moment of arrival. They're taking the temperature, giving masks if you don't have one, spraying all around, how the luggage moving around and being sprayed everywhere so that no infection. You're having your room locked until the guest personally, and of course for the players as well, open the area. No housekeeping is entering unless you ask for specific spraying or whatever, so that we don't spread this. The measures being taken that you're having transportation 50% of the capacity, hotels on 50% on the capacity, roads, let alone having all these areas attended by the army when they have these specific promotions or let me say precautions in the streets to show that we care for the health.
Yes. Mrs. Nahum, in other countries, several tournaments and international championships were cancelled, but Egypt was determined to hold this tournament. How can we build on this to promote tourism?
This is a very good question because we have very good item or pillow or pillar that we should relate to. In the rest of the countries, if you host any tournament, it has to be locked and closed and you don't have an open air area to host anything. In Egypt, we have all areas open air because of the weather.
Yes.
So you have the sun always as a precaution. You have the empty space where you can have number of people, but they're not gathered next to each other.
Proper ventilation.
Exactly. The ventilation itself is the area where you say this, the AC or the non-ventilation makes the virus more active. Now you don't have that.
Properly ventilated areas are...
Exactly. For the social distancing, you're having the space. We are always having
spaces. We have seen the social distance in the inaugural session. It was intact.
Exactly. And with the measures as well.
Yes.
It's not only that you're having open air, so you don't wear a mask. No, you'd wear a mask
and
you
are distance.
Keeping the temperature. You're keeping the spraying, you're keeping the distance, and in addition you're having the sun. So this is an impact that everybody could see, that you're always having an open air. And I believe this has been shown in all the filmings, in all the promotional films, in the tournaments that we have announced, in non-cancelling. Mind you that cancellation or continuing is not only our subject. There is a committee, not related to us, related to the handball.
Yes, to the federation.
Exactly. So it's not us that we only decide. But the countries is approving. The, as you said, the federation of handball is approving. I'm sure they have inspected the places before coming, what are the measures that are we are taking. They have exchanged with Egypt government or Ministry of Health, federations as well. What are, how are we keeping their teams in good health?
Yes.
They're not just sending teams to be, God forbid, having any viruses.
Yes.
But unless this is taken correctly and with the right measures, they wouldn't have approved it. So it is a great step to have that.
Yes. Also, Mrs. Nahum, how can we, in the crisis that the whole world is facing, how can we promote tourism, and what kinds of incentives can be offered to tourism tourists to encourage them to visit Egypt? And of course, you're the expert here, the marketing and the sales expert. If you can tell us what can be done in order to revitalize this hardly hit industry.
Well, in order not to repeat what we have said, all with the promoting films, the promotional offers that are being done and so on. But if you talk about incentives, there is a couple of things that we could do. First, to stress on having open air areas, stress on the weather, stress on opportunities for what we call fam trips or familiarization trips, where we familiarize the people coming should be reporters, should be different governmental organizations that are related to COVID, who should approve and certify you or give the blessing, as we say, that you are taking the precautions, that you are...
The green light.
Absolutely, that you are doing the whole measures that should keep your customers safe. If, God forbid, something happens, how are you treating the case itself? So the process. So this is one of the incentives.
Once entering the country till they leave.
Absolutely. In addition, locally, we are showing everybody how important their health is, how are we taking care of their health, not only locally, because again, as we say, we are doing this locally, but the media now doesn't make anything confidential or locked
and
within
it. Social media, everything is goes viral.
Exactly, and everybody of us within the tourism or outside the tourism have either relatives, friends, families, around the world. So when you share your photo that you have been to Upper Egypt and you're enjoying the sun, everything is measured with the mask, with the precautions and so on, this means a message. But stressing on the farm trips, on the green lights, as you said, or the certifications, and on having guests safe, feedback of customers, foreign customers when they visit Egypt, and talk about the positive areas and how they enjoyed the weather being in social distance, as well as the measures. Now it's related. We were talking before about safety, now it's health safety. It's very important now to talk about it in order to make sure that when we have our new projects, integrations like the museum, the Grand Museum, it's only it's not only a blocked space. You have open areas for the kids, so you could keep the kids in the open air.
And I also believe that there is going to be hotels.
Absolutely.
So, like a complex.
Absolutely.
Where you can find everything.
Of course, and not only that. Still, you have the surrounding of the sun, the weather, the open air.
The hospitality,
the hospitality, of course, is one of the major things. But talking about these two items now, it's two pillars now. Your health, safety, that you will go on a vacation, enjoy it, and come back safely, of course, without any measures.
Mrs. Nagam, how do you see the efforts exerted by the Ministry of Tourism and Antiquities and Minister Khaled Dilaneni to revitalize the sector despite the global emergency that has brought the whole world to a standstill? For instance, we have seen Minister Khaled Dilaneni inviting ambassadors from EU countries to the City of Love and Peace, Sharm el Sheikh, to ride bicycles and walk around, have a marathon. How do you see the efforts exerted so far?
That's exactly, I will not say enhancing, but assuring everybody that we work on this social distancing, open air, you have sports. This is what we always say, keep yourself away from any bad habits and go into
stay
the
healthy.
Good habits and stay healthy. So staying healthy means fresh air, away from
proper
viruses,
absolutely
proper food. In addition to, you're having the sun, the sea, so you're playing sports in safe areas. You're talking about the sea, and this is a natural thing.
And there's no crowdedness.
Absolutely. We have beautiful beaches and quite big. Abroad, you don't have such open air, big beaches without any space or with a good spacing between people. So this is the enhancement. Absolutely, we do have an area where we should emphasize on what's going on, the vaccine and what's the precautions and what's going on in order to ensure that everybody, when they visit our website, this is something that's alarming. I'm sure they go now and visit this particularly in order to make sure that they have the right measures and that everything is properly measured. So we need definitely to emphasize on this, in addition to the hosting and to the activities that have been made of hosting customers, VIPs,
celebrities,
important people who can relay the message properly about Egypt and what we are making as precautions for this COVID-19.
Yes. Mrs. Nagam, what are the challenges that you currently see facing the industry, and how can we overcome them?
Well, the
main... Aside from the COVID, of course.
Of course. But it is affecting them. Actually, it's having no flights coming to Egypt. Mm. Customers are having their own fear.
Mm. Well, the situation is fluid about like PCRs, possible lockdowns. So they think a lot of times before taking
Absolutely.
The decision.
Absolutely, the fear of, and not only that, their countries is locking them somehow, or taking measures that if they travel, if they travel somewhere. Mm-hmm. In some countries, and unfortunately Egypt from these countries, because we have not finalized the vaccine issue, or it's not yet in process. Mm-hmm. So it's a measure that they take 14 days lockdown
quarantine.
Or quarantine. Mm-hmm. So this is one of the major things that we have to look into, promoting the new areas like the Gem, the
Grand Egyptian Museum.
Exactly, mm-hmm. and the new museums and so on, and precautions is one of the things that we should enhance in our websites and the new programs in order to ensure that when the customers are back, which is very soon, I believe, because the vaccine, everybody is thinking that they should, or the nation should have the vaccine before end of September. Mm-hmm. That's the plans in general, which means that we should have a great winter, and we should have a lot of customers next year. So we should be prepared for that.
We have our fingers crossed, and we look forward that the situation, this COVID nightmare, will be over and the situation will be back to normal.
Hopefully.
And even better. Finally, we would like to thank you so much, Mrs. Nagam Mohammad Ali, tourism expert and a sales and managing director of a group of hotels. Thank you so much for being with us on The Breakfast Show, and thank you so much for your insight.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And dear viewers, now we move on to a quick break, and then we'll be back to resume The Breakfast Show live on Mile TV International.